Hello there, this is Dave Allen and I'm looking at iMovie on the iPad today. I'm looking at how to add sound. Well, I've started off this little project here. I've put some video in there, so let's go into that there. And let's add some sounds to it. Well, to start off by adding sounds, what you can do is tap on that one there and you can go into your theme music. Okay, so we've got our theme music there, and the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to tap on this one here, Bright, and it will add theme music. And it adds the theme music so it covers the whole of the track. And there's not much more you can do with it apart from that. If you tap on it, say do a double tap, I've got audio clip settings, so you can set the level of audio on there. That's pretty easy. You can delete the clip, and you can also drag the clip out of the timeline. But what I wanted to do was I wanted to add other sounds to it. So let's go back into audio again, and we've got sound effects. Now in the sound effects, you can tap on, say, an alarm, for instance. You put an alarm in there, and that alarm will play. If you could just do me the favour of clicking on the like button, I'd appreciate it. Thanks. What about if you want to add some sound effects and they're not included as part of the iMovie for iPad? Now, what I first thought was that I would have to go into this one here, into apps. So I'd have to select iMovie and then I'd be able to drag sounds into this area here, like I have done. And then I'd be able to find those on the iPad in the iMovie application. Now, that didn't work. So I'm just going to select delete and delete those documents. So the way to get sounds into your iPad for use within iPad is to go to this one here, go to music. And what I've done is I've put a tick in this one here, sound effects. So I've told it to sync music, selected playlists, artists, albums and genres. And I've selected sound effects. Now I couldn't select any of these here, so I just made a specific one that's called sound effects. And once you've done that, you sync it up and then you go into your iPad. So here we are in the iPad now, and I'm going to go into playlists, and there you go, I've got my sound effects in there, look. So these are the sound effects that I've got in the playlist within iTunes on my Mac, and I've got them available now to use here. Now the first thing to notice with this video that the track is 46 seconds long. That's how long the video is. So if I'm going to get this bus interior and tap on that there and add it, it's going to add it to the whole of the thing there, and I can't really do much else with it. So if I tap on that, it doesn't give me any way to extend or decrease the length of that track. So let's just backspace that and get it out of the way. Let's go for something a little bit shorter. You see this one here is 37 seconds. So let's just tap on that one there. And as you can see, it goes and starts from the point where the playhead is. So that's pretty good. But what if I want to make it shorter? Tap on it. And you see I've got little yellow dots there. All I've got to do is drag that in and I've got it shorter. So that's how you get tracks in there and you can make them so that they go where you want them to go. Let's just do it again. Let's choose a nice short one here, Animal Pig Oink. Tap that one there, put it in there.
There was that film.
So we got a little piggy in there. So as you can see, I was able to take that and move it to exactly where I wanted it to go to, and I can put it into a place where I can see that there is no sound in that particular portion. So it's in between where I'm talking. Now, if you can't see the wave on there, then obviously you need to press that button there. And then you can see more of what's going on there. So let's go and grab something else, put something else in there. Steam released. And as you can see, it is possible to have one bit of audio that comes across the top of another one there. So if you're looking for a specific effect that's made out of two sounds, then you can do that. So we've got an alarm sound with the steam as well, so let's put the metallic one in there. In fact, we've got three in there now. How about that, so? So there you go. That's how you can add sounds and position them and change the length of them if you want to in iMovie for iPad. Thanks for watching the video, and why don't you check out the other videos? Here's two of them. There's one video there and one video there that you can click on and go and have a look at now. And don't forget that you can also subscribe. Talk to you again soon. Bye-bye now.